Today, IQ is an important and hotly debated aspect of psychology and education. It has become part of our everyday vocabulary, and tests have popped up all over the internet. While IQ may not predict someone's success, it's undeniable that the measurement of intelligence and its implications have had a huge effect on the way that our society makes decisions. The term IQ, and much of the common belief surrounding it, was introduced by the work of one man, Lewis Terman. Born in rural Johnson County, Indiana, in 1877, Terman was the 12th child out of 14 siblings. Unlike his brothers and sisters, he preferred intellectual games and reading over sports or outdoor play, and he felt physically outclassed by his friends. Back then, few farm kids stayed in school past the 8th grade, but Terman was ambitious for more education. With loans from his family, Terman excelled as he attended Central Normal College for his bachelor's degree, Indiana University for his master's, and Clark University for his PhD. However, Terman is best known for his work at Stanford, where he made lasting contributions to the field of psychology known as education psychology. His work on human intelligence and genius has shaped our view of people and success dramatically, and even now his work is still being cited. Soon after arriving at Stanford, he rose up to become the first prominent scholar that Stanford ever had, serving as the psychology department chair for 2 decades and transforming it from an afterthought into a top-ranked, highly regarded program. One of the first and most impactful things that Terman worked on at Stanford was the Stanford-Binet Intelligence Test. It was an intelligence test created originally by French researcher Binet to help the French government identifying slow children for support. Terman and his Stanford colleagues translated the test and adapted the concept for US schools. They made critical adjustments and improvements so that the test could be used on almost any individual to test for general intelligence, which Terman felt was as innate and measurable as height or weight. The release of this test almost single-handedly introduced IQ testing into America, and the test is still one of the most common IQ tests administered today. With this amazing feat, Terman started the American obsession with IQ and also launched the field of intelligence testing. Building off of his interest in intelligence, Terman launched a genetic study of genius, which he hoped would prove to others that the stigma of smart children being early ripe, early rot was not true. From his own experience growing up in rural Indiana, he wanted to show people that precocious kids were normal like everyone else and could excel in what they did later in life. To conduct the study, he identified over 1,500 elementary schoolers from California with IQs of above 140. These subjects, who came to be known as termites, were extensively analyzed and interviewed constantly throughout their entire lives. In fact, the study established a longitudinal form of research and is still going on now as the longest and the oldest longitudinal study in the world. The results of the studies are mixed. In some ways, the termites were exceptional, and in other ways, they were completely normal. For example, the termites earned bachelor's degrees at 10 times the national rate, and they did so during the Great Depression. They swarmed to graduate school and ended up in jobs that paid almost 2 times the national average. However, IQ did not affect social statistics such as rate of death, drug addiction, or even crime. Behind all of Terman's success and influence was a more disturbing vision. Terman was extremely interested in eugenics, the social movement aiming to improve the human race by allowing only intelligent humans to breed, while sterilizing those who are below a certain threshold. He was active in the eugenics organization called the Human Betterment Foundation, and it was obvious from his letters that he believed society would deteriorate without eugenics. His dream of a world based on intellectual merit alone was what pushed him to some of his greatest works, such as the Stanford-Binet Intelligence Test. He thought that being able to measure people would help in engineering a more efficient nation where the brightest citizens would control the top jobs, and those with lower IQs would be institutionalized and prevented from having children. In 1956, Terman passed away after a long fight with recurrent tuberculosis at the age of 79. It's undeniable that Terman changed the face of psychology with IQ testing and the idea of longitudinal studies. The president of the American Psychological Association, Terman was both stubborn and energetic about his ideas. Like many others of his time, he supported eugenics until his later years. However, despite his flawed intent, Terman's legacy will always live on as a great positive influence on psychology.